I should point out, it did have, there were some holes that were burnt into it. But it was robust enough to land despite having some holes burnt into it, you know, yeah.
Did you just hear what Elon Musk revealed about Ship 38 of Flight 11? Is he serious? Well, let's discuss. Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started.
Elon Musk recently appeared on the Joe Rogan Experience on October 31st, 2025, where he shared new, previously undisclosed insights about the aftermath of Starship Flight 11 and revealed more details about the entire Starship program. In this video, we'll break it all down for you, one by one. Just weeks earlier, SpaceX's Starship Flight 11 had launched from Starbase, Texas, lighting up the sky on October 13th and marking another milestone in the company's ongoing quest to make rockets fully and rapidly reusable. During the three-hour interview, Musk and Rogan covered a wide range of topics, from Starship updates, government regulation and space crowding, to Mars colonization and the evolution of Starbase itself. But for anyone following Starship's progress, the first half hour was where the most fascinating details emerged. A detailed breakdown of Flight 11's successes, the lessons learned, and the bold path ahead. Joe Rogan began by recalling his own experience watching the launch in person, calling it one of the absolute coolest. They work for the flight and keep the flight from the last masses that were shaking by the leg. He described how the ground trembled beneath his feet, the roar of the engines hitting his chest before his ears. Musk smiled as Rogan relived the moment, adding that Flight 11 represented the final test for the Block 2 version of Starship, the last before the upgraded Block 3 takes over future flights. The rocket lifted off from SpaceX's Boca Chica launch site, separating smoothly from its booster before the upper stage continued halfway around the world, eventually splashing down in the Indian Ocean after about 40 minutes in flight. Covering roughly 7,000 miles, it was the farthest and longest Starship test yet, and Musk called it one of the most informative flights in the program's history. The discussion quickly moved to why Flight 11 was such a crucial milestone. Musk explained that the company intentionally pushed Starship to its limits, testing how much stress the spacecraft could endure while still surviving re-entry. This mission, he said, was not about perfection, but about gathering data from extreme conditions. To demonstrate that, SpaceX engineers even removed heat shield tiles from the most exposed areas of the ship's upper stage. Those tiles, made of durable ceramic materials, are designed to protect the spacecraft during re-entry when it slams into Earth's atmosphere at nearly 17,000 miles per hour, about 25 times the speed of sound. Without them, the ship would be vulnerable to superheated plasma temperatures hotter than the surface of the sun. Yet, even with those tiles deliberately missing, Starship held together and managed a soft landing in the ocean. It had some holes burned into it, Musk admitted, but it was robust enough to land. The fact that it could survive such punishment was a clear sign that SpaceX's stainless steel design could handle re-entries far more brutally than any operational mission would ever experience. The footage, powered by SpaceX's Starlink network, showed the ship glowing red hot as it passed through layers of plasma that temporarily blocked all radio contact. Only once it slowed did communications restore, revealing a battered but intact vehicle descending into the ocean. That data, Musk said, is now being fed directly into the development of the next iteration, the Block 3 Starship, which will feature a stronger heat shield, improved flaps for atmospheric control, and upgraded engines. The heart of the discussion came when Rogan brought up critics who mocked SpaceX for its frequent explosions during testing. He quoted one pundit who called Musk a stupid for the number of failed flights. Musk responded, "You have to find the corners of the box." He explained that pushing hardware to failure is how you truly understand its limits. Every explosion, he said, is data, a step toward perfection. For Flight 11, that meant intentionally creating worst-case scenarios, from missing heat shield tiles to high-speed re-entry angles. If you're not blowing up rockets, you're not pushing hard enough, Musk added. You can't learn the limits by staying safe. From there, Musk shifted to the technical side, discussing the engines that make Starship's performance possible. Flight 11 used the company's Raptor 2 engines, but the upcoming Block 3 version will feature the new Raptor 3. Musk called them simpler, lighter, and nearly twice as powerful as their predecessors. "It looks like parts are missing," he joked, holding up a prototype during the podcast. Each Raptor 3 produces more thrust than all four engines on a Boeing 747 combined, yet it's compact enough to fit 33 of them into the massive Super Heavy booster. Together, they will generate over 10,000 tons of thrust at liftoff, roughly 5 times the power of NASA's Space Launch System rocket. Musk also explained the concept of hot staging, in which the upper stage ignites its engines while still attached to the booster. Though it looks dramatic, it increases efficiency and reliability. To make it work safely, the inner stage now has built-in vents that allow the exhaust flames to escape without damaging the hardware. As Rogan listened, the conversation turned to the long-term vision, making Starship not just reusable, but rapidly reusable. Musk emphasized that Starship is the first rocket in history designed for full and quick reuse, where both stages return safely and can fly again with minimal refurbishment. "Earth's gravity is brutal," he said. "You need tremendous energy to reach orbit, and most rockets are thrown away after one use. That's like scrapping an airplane after every flight. SpaceX proved with the Falcon 9 that partial reuse can slash costs dramatically, but Starship aims to take that concept further, achieving airplane-like turnaround times. We can get this right," Musk said, "the cost of reaching orbit could drop 100-fold. That changes everything. It makes Mars possible." He said 2026 will be the year when true reusability becomes real, with Starship flying frequently and reliably enough to make access to orbit as common as air travel. Musk also discussed how Flight 11 demonstrated both orbital delivery and safe return. The test included deploying dummy payloads before deorbiting and returning through the atmosphere. During re-entry, the ship's stainless steel hull endured plasma so bright it turned night into day. Communications dropped out temporarily before Starlink reconnected. When signals returned, the spacecraft was still intact. That, Musk said, proved that their design, built from strong, inexpensive steel, can outperform lighter but more fragile carbon fiber. "Steel is cheap, strong, and can take the heat," he explained. "It's the right choice for something that goes up and comes back this fast." While Flight 11 didn't attempt a booster catch, the daring maneuver where the Super Heavy stage is caught mid-air by giant mechanical arms known as Mechazilla, Musk confirmed that this will happen soon. Flight 12, scheduled for December, will make another catch attempt. Musk said the next flights will also begin testing in-orbit refueling, another critical step for deep space missions to the Moon and Mars. Those tests are expected in 2026, followed by uncrewed Mars missions in 2028 and, if all goes well, crewed missions soon after. Flight 11 proved that a spacecraft could survive extreme re-entry and return safely. It wasn't flawless, but it was proof that Starship's fundamental concept works. Engineers are now studying every piece of data from that flight, examining burn patterns, testing the durability of the heat shield, and fine-tuning the flight control systems. Musk called it iteration by fire, a phrase that sums up SpaceX's philosophy. Each flight, successful or not, feeds the next version. Whether Starship achieves routine spaceflight by 2030 or takes a few more years, one thing is clear: the pace of progress is accelerating. Each test, each flight, each discussion pushes humanity a little closer to a multi-planetary future. Flight 11's controlled chaos, the missing tiles, the glowing re-entry, the soft ocean landing, symbolized SpaceX's philosophy in action. Learn fast, take risks, and never stop iterating.
Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.